Now friends, see that here one question is there in this particular question. Two sole traders are there, Vinaya and Prakash, and they are provided their balance sheet. And this particular balance sheet of the Vinaya and Prakash. Prakash is a businessman, Vinaya is a businessman, woman, and they are decided to amalgamate their business. Now two different businesses come together and they start their own new firm. And for that purpose, first of all, we should find out their purchase consideration. We should find out the purchase consideration. Now, how we will find out the purchase consideration? Calculation of the purchase consideration. Last lecture, so we already considered how to calculate the purchase consideration. In that, first of all, we should draw the three columns, particulars, then the Vinaya and the Prakash, their column, we have to show separately. First of all, we have to consider all assets taken over at book value or agreed value. All asset taken over at book value or agreed value. If you see that in our sum, only book value is there. Balance sheet values are called as a book values, and there is no agreed value. So what we have to consider, only book value we have to write. So in that book value, cash, bank balances, debtors, stock, building, bill receivable, these are the values we have to consider. So here, first item we have to show cash. Asset side, first item, it is a book value. Cash is there, that we have to consider. The next item, bank balance 4,800. So we have to write the bank balance 4,800. It's a Vinaya's bank balance 4,800. Then debtors 12,000 and 9,000. So we have to consider debtors 12,000 and 9,000. We have to write debtors. After debtors, next asset, stock 6,900 and 4,550. We have to write here next item, stock. After writing this stock, next is building 10,500 and 6,000. So we have to write the next item, building 10,500 and 6,000. After recording this, next is bills receivable 8,000. The bills receivable 8,000. So see, friends, we recorded the all assets at book value. Then after that, we have to find out the total of assets. The total Vinaya's assets total 42,400 and Prakash assets total 19,850. After recording the total assets, we calculate this total value. Then after that, we have to find out liabilities taken over, and this liability we have to deduct from the total assets. Now, what kinds of liabilities are there? The creditors, bills payable, bank overdraft. These are the liabilities. That liability we have to show. The first item, creditors 3,500 and 2,000. So we should write here creditors 3,500 and 2,000. Then after that, next, bills payable 1,000 is there. Only Vinaya's bills paper is there that we have to show here. 1000 value. After taking bills paper, next item in our liability side, bank overdraft, 3200. The bank overdraft, this will we have to show bank overdraft. After recording bank overdraft, we have to find out the total of liabilities, that is 3500, 1000, and four. So it will be the 4500. Then Prakash credit us 2000, bank overdraft 3200, total is 5200. It means we have a total assets 42,400 and total liabilities 4,500. So total assets minus total liabilities. Total asset A 42,400 and total liabilities B 4,500. So 42,400 minus 4,500. What amount will come? So how we will calculate that 42,400 minus 4,500, the rest of the value 37,900. Then Prakash total assets 19,850 and Prakash total liabilities 5,200. So total assets minus total liabilities. So here 19,850 minus 5,200. The rest of the value is 14,650. So see friends, these values are called as a purchase consideration. This particular Vinaya's purchase consideration 37,900 and Prakash purchase consideration 14,650. So I hope you understood how to calculate the purchase consideration value. Is there
sir,
any
yes sir, I have one question. Why we have not considered reserve and capital?
See that from liabilities. Reserves and capitals are not a liability. Reserves and capitals are not a current liabilities and fixed current liabilities. There are two types of liabilities, current liability and non-current liabilities. The reserves and surplus, it is a non-current liabilities. We have to consider only current liabilities. Current liability means what? Those liability which can be paid within the 12 months, that is called as a current liabilities. Creditors, bills payable, and bank overdraft, these are the current liabilities. That's why we have to consider only current liabilities. Okay. So any doubt here? Yes. Do you have any doubt? So I hope you understood this question. This question.
Sir, I am understood the capital, but what about the reserve? What is the meaning of reserve?
Reserves, it is a part of profit. Whatever profit earned by the company or firm, they keep as a reserve. Reserves and surpluses. Reserves and surpluses for the various purposes. And these reserves, they will keep. Reserves, we cannot say that it is our liability. Reserves means that it is a one type of profit. Whatever profit earned, some part of the portion we have to keep aside as a reserves. And capital brought by the partners, or if it is a sole trader, it is brought by the sole trader. So it is not a liability, it is a capital. We cannot say that it is a liability. Okay. only current liabilities we have to consider whenever calculating the our purchase consideration. And whenever we will calculate the total assets, the total asset includes the fixed assets. It means land and building, furniture. Then current asset also we have to consider. Cash, bank balance, debtor, stock. So these are the current assets. Building is a fixed asset. So all assets which is taken over by the new firm, it will be considered. But always we have to consider first, we have to consider the aggregate value. If the aggregate value is not there, then we will consider the book value. Okay, book value means the balance sheet value. Balance sheet values are there. If the problem is silent about the aggregate value, that time we have to consider the book value. Okay, do you have any doubt?
No, sir, got it.
Okay, so these are small sum. In this particular sum, we have to understand first how to calculate the purchase consideration. Now, friends, I hope you understand this particular question. But one more thing that you have to keep in mind, the last lecture, I explained one question, problem number two. I hope you already wrote in your notebook. If you are not wrote these answers, it will be very difficult to understand. How many students wrote the answers? How many students prepare their own notebook?
I have done.
Show your thumb in our chat box, those who completed the work. How many students prepare? How many students prepare their own notebook? Whether you prepare your notebook or not, whether you are interested to study or not. Very few students are interested to do the work. See that accountancy, it is not a only theoretical part. It's a practical part. And you, without understanding the practical part, and without understanding the writing work, you cannot understand the concepts and the how their terminology of the accountancy. So you should write in your notebook. So it is very difficult. One thing you have to keep in mind, you should study all practical part, then you can understand the theoretical part also. Okay, now I want to share with you again same our notes. I have shared with PDF form. How many students wrote the multiple choice questions? Yes.
Sir, PPT तुम्ही group वर send करू शकता का?
Group वरती already sent आहे. Group वरती already
sir तुम्ही जी PPT share केलेली आहे सर, आता जे multiple question वगैरे आहे त्यात सर problem number 5-4 हे आहेत, पण मल्टीपल चॉईस क्वेश्चन असं काही नाहीये सर पेज.
पीडीएफ मध्ये मी दिलेले आहे, तुम्हाला पीडीएफ दिलेले आहे ना, त्यामध्ये आहे,
तर प्लीज रिसेंड करा ना.
ठीक आहे, मी परत सेंड करतो. पण हे लेक्चर मध्ये ते अपडेट झालं पाहिजे, नाहीतर मी पुढे जाणार त्याला काय अर्थ नाहीये. आणि मी लेक्चर्स रेकॉर्डेड व्हिडिओज पण टाकलेत, तुम्ही ते बघत राहा. आता जो आता मी प्रॉब्लेम सॉल्व्ह केलाय त्याची रेकॉर्डिंग सुद्धा मी तुम्हाला परत पाठवतो. बट वन ओनली लिसनिंग इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टंट. तुम्ही आलात आणि बसलात ते महत्वाचं नाही. फर्स्ट यू शुड अंडरस्टँड, यू शुड राईट, यू शुड प्रॅक्टिस. अंडरस्टँडिंग करा, रायटिंग करा, प्रॅक्टिस करा, तर यू विल अंडरस्टँड द ओव्हरऑल थिंग अबाउट द अकाउंटन्स. हा काय थेरी सब्जेक्ट नाही आहे, काय नुसतं बडबडलं आणि कळालं. दिस थिंग्स यू शुड कीप इन माइंड. मी फक्त बडबडणार आणि तुम्हाला समजणार असं नाही आहे. तर प्रॅक्टिकल वर्क इज इसेन्शियल. आता मला कळत नाही किती जण प्रॅक्टिकल वर्क करतात. व्हेरी फ्यू स्टुडंट्स आर डुईंग द प्रॅक्टिकल वर्क and it's very difficult. So you should do the practical also. Or me te stop karto, aapla ekas lecture hai. Tumhala mi hi video YouTube varti send karto. Tumhi atta cha lecture cha je problem hai to tumcha vahi madhe lihun kada. You should write the question and answer in your notebook whatever I discussed today. So it is because fourth lecture, you don't have the fourth lectures. And one thing you have to keep in mind, tumhi pratyek teacher la sanga ja timetable pramane lecture ghya. Ani ek lakshat theva, ek lecture zhalyanantar tumhala 10 minute cha gap hai. If you see the timetable, every lectures after completing one lectures you have the 10 minutes gap. That time tyamadhe tumhi tumchi adjustment karu shakta, tumhi round marun yeu shakta, pani piun yeu shakta. कारण दुसऱ्या परत ऑनलाईन मध्ये जाण्यासाठी 10 मिनिटाचा गॅप असतो. तुमचं अगोदरचं लेक्चर ते 8 संपलं पाहिजे. आय होप यू अंडरस्टूड व्हॉट आय से. कळतंय मी तुम्हाला काय बोलतोय?
यस सर.
आणि तुम्ही त्या सगळ्या टीचरला स्ट्रिक्टली सांगा, पंडाळे सरांनी सांगितलंय, नाहीतर मग जाऊन कंप्लेंट करा कॉलेजमध्ये. असं असं करा, लेट नाही आलं पाहिजे, टायमावरती आलं पाहिजे. तुम्ही टाइमवर येतात ना, आणि जर लेक्चर होत नसेल तर डायरेक्टली त्यांनी कळवलं पाहिजे का लेक्चर नाही. मी तो गेल्या आठवड्यात नव्हतं घेतलं, मी सांगितलं मग ह्या कारणामुळे मी लेक्चर नाही घेतलं. तर ते प्रॉपरली लेक्चर्स होतील, प्रॉपरली तुमचं स्टडी होईल. आता कोण पण कधी पण येऊन लेक्चर घेणं हे इट्स नॉट गुड काइंड ऑफ स्टडी. तुम्ही त्यांना इन्फॉर्म करा, तसं ऑल टीचर्स सगळ्या टीचर्सला इन्फॉर्म करा. ठीक आहे, आणि लेक्चरचे टाइम टेबल 6:30 त्यानंतर 6:30 किती आहे, किती वाजेपर्यंत लेक्चर आहे, पहिलं लेक्चर टाइम टेबल असेल सगळ्यांकडे
6:30 सर.
6:32
फर्स्ट लेक्चर इज गोइंग ऑन 6:30
7:10 नंतर परत 10 मिनिटाचा गॅप आहे. देन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 7:20 समटाइम इट मे बी स्टार्ट.
40 मिनिटाचं लेक्चर असतं ना ऑनलाईन, तर पहिलं 6:30 ते 7:10 त्याच्यानंतर सेकंड लेक्चर 7:25 चा चालू.
मध्ये गॅप आहे ना?
येस
सर. हा
मग नंतर 7:25 ला सुरू झाल्यानंतर कधी पर्यंत संपत? 8:00 8:05 संपत, आणि त्यानंतर परत 8:15 लेक्चर. 10 मिनिटाचे गॅप आहेत ना?
Yes sir.
You have the 10 minutes gap every lecture. तर तेवढं तुम्ही त्या तुमच्या टीचरला सांगा. तुमच्या टीचर्सला ते सगळं सांगा, नसेल माहित तर ते माहिती करून घ्यायला सांगा त्यांना. कारण आपलं प्रॅक्टिकल लेक्चर असतं, आपलं महत्वाचं लेक्चर आहे, दोन दोन सब्जेक्ट आहेत आपले, त्यामुळे आपलं महत्वाचं तुम्हाला नसेल महत्वाचं वाटत तर नका येऊ. पण एवढे कमी 36 स्टुडंट्स 35 स्टुडंट्स प्रेझेंट आहेत, व्हेरी फ्यू स्टुडंट्स प्रेझेंट. सर मी आलो तेव्हा चारच जण आले, तसं झालं नाही पाहिजे. ठीक आहे, तर मी तुम्हाला आजचं जे झालं ते शेअर करतो.
नोटेड सर.
अँड वन थिंग यू हॅव टू कीप इन माइंड, व्हॉट एव्हर आय डिस्कस दॅट यू शुड राईट इन युअर नोटबुक. जेवढं आहे ते नोटबुकला लिहा, नाहीतर त्याला काय अर्थ नाही. ठीक आहे, यू डोंट हॅव द लेक्चर्स राईट नाव, फोर्थ लेक्चर तर ऑफ आहे तुमचं, तुम्ही ती स्टडी करू शकता. ओके, बाय.